A Concise History of the Coldstream Short-Haired Cat. The Coldstream Short-Haired Cat is a very rare breed. Coldstream cats are renowned for their amazing ability to remain still for long periods of time, and also for their ability to remain silent. The Coldstream cat was originally bred by the legendary philanderer and well-known cat breeder Captain Clive Curtius, late of the Hussars, towards the end of the last century. Captain Curtius bred the cat at the request of an old friend of his, Colonel H.P. Saucy Muldrew, late of the Coldstream Guards. The Colonel was a quiet man, who, when he joined the Guards, missed his cat Cedric terribly. Life in the Coldstream Guards is hard, and many guards are lonely. Consequently, Colonel Muldrew asked his old friend whether it would be possible to breed a type of cat especially to be companions for lonely guardsmen. The cat, like the guardsmen, would have to remain still for long periods of time, and would also have to remain quiet. Captain Curtius initially thought it unlikely that he could produce such a breed and told the good colonel so. However, in the summer of 1879 fate was to take a hand. In a small town named Coalpit Heath, near Bristol, England, a tabby short-haired cat named Rowntree Patricia Avril, owned by the Reverend M.J. Mollahampton, gave birth to 5 kittens. 3 of these kittens were in every way normal. However, the 2 remaining, male, kittens regularly exhibited a peculiar ability to remain both still and silent for long periods of time. These kittens became local celebrities, and it was whilst Captain Curtius was visiting the city of Bristol that year that they came to his attention. Immediately upon hearing of the existence of these kittens, Captain Curtius arranged an appointment to visit the Reverend Mollahampton at the latter's home. This he did on the following Sunday. It transpired that the Reverend Mollahampton's older brother, Henry, was currently serving in the Coldstream Guards, and so the Reverend gentleman was disposed to allow Captain Curtius to breed from his by now infamous cats. It is not well known, but the term catatonic was first used to describe the Reverend Mollahampton's kittens. Captain Curtius tried for 2 years to breed from the clergyman's cats, but with no luck. It was not until autumn 1881 that Curtius succeeded. During the summer, a similar mutant strain was discovered in the Isle of Wight, 3 females of which Curtius was able to purchase. It was only when these 3 cats were introduced to the Reverend Mollahampton's pair that the breed began to establish itself. Curtius was later heard to say that he thought that the original problem had been that the cats he'd introduced simply moved too fast for the Mollahampton's cats. By 1885, Curtius had established a viable breeding population of well over 30 cats. Occasionally over the next couple of decades, the mutant strain reappeared, and when this happened, the resultant cats were added to the breeding population. By 1890, Curtius was satisfied enough with the breed to present a dozen kittens to the now elderly Colonel Muldrew, who kept a pair for himself and presented the rest to his old regiment. It is a little known fact, but the Coldstream cat was directly responsible for the adoption of the Busby as headgear by the Coldstream Guards. The reason for this is that the guards could safely keep their beloved cats under their hats whilst on duty. Even to this day, one can occasionally see the tip of a tail sticking out from under a guard's busby whilst the Coldstream Regiment is on duty outside Buckingham Palace. This article was taken from the 1910 summer edition of the Military Cat Breeders' Gazette, published by the rather dubious and questionable publishing house of Fleet Street, London.